Public Affairs Broadcasting. Special programming from Rockingham County Radio, rcrlive.com.
Good morning. I'm Johnny Bowles, Rockingham County Emergency Services Director.
And I'm Tommy Curry with the Fire Marshal's Office.
And we're here this morning to talk to you a little bit about heating safety and holiday safety, since we've got the holidays coming up.
Yes. I know that last month we talked a little bit about heater safety, but I wanted to go back and reiterate some more on heat and safety. In the last several weeks, if you've been watching any of the news and all like that, you noticed that we've had some, luckily not here in Rockingham County, but in the neighboring counties, we've had some rash of heater fires. I know in Thomasville, they had actually had two homes that were destroyed by fire, but it was due to a heater that was left too close to a bed. You never should to leave your when you got these heaters going, and you know, and our temperatures have been going up and down, you know, but you should never take any type of heater, be it kerosene, electric, or anything like that, and leave it too close to combustible material like the bedding and things like that. And from what I understand, that is what's happened in the fire in Thomasville. It was too close to the bed. We've had, I know, some wood stove issues with fires. And we've had an actual firefighter lost his life in the last week or so, not fighting fire, but in his own home caught on fire. And his small child is in a burn unit now, and you know, fighting for her life. So we really, really need to be cautious out there when it comes to with the heaters, wood stoves, your electric heaters, your kerosene heaters. All these appliances are safe if they're used and used properly. You know, that's the key issue right there when we say used properly. You've got a little small heater in the bedroom, you know, trying to keep it warm during the night when you're sleeping. You got small children, if you got it in one of their rooms, you know, covers are liable to go anywhere. The bed, blankets, sheets, you know, with a kid during the night sleeping, he's liable to toss them blankets and sheets everywhere. And the next thing you know, where did they land?
Top of the heater.
Top of the heater. You know, then they're sitting there. Some of the heaters are supposed to be designed, if they get too hot, you know, in a confined space, they're supposed to shut off, but sometimes they won't, you know. And then if the heater's just at a certain distance and it just keeps constantly throwing that heat to that blanket, you know, it's going to eventually, the blanket's going to catch on fire. You know, the material and stuff like that a lot of the manufacturers make have some type of fire retardant in them, but yet they still will burn.
Right.
You know.
And I know, what is the distance recommended to keep people, or keep items away from your heater and keep kids freeze zone?
The very minimum is 3 feet. The minimum is 3 feet. We'd prefer 5 feet. You know, but you know, if you keep it away, at least 3 feet away. But again, you know, we say 3 feet. You go in some bedrooms, you know, in some of the houses, and the bedrooms, you know, by the time you put the bed, the furniture, and everything else in there, do you have that 3 feet? A lot of times, no, you don't. You don't have the 3 feet you can leave. And when I say 3 feet, I'm not saying just 3 feet in one direction. That's 3 feet in all directions. Cool. You know, and so in a home, in a bedroom setting, a lot of times it's hard to get that, you know, 3 feet clearance and all there. In a kid's room, you know, a typical kid nowadays, in their room, you know, we would like for them to try to keep their room clean, neat, and straight. Do they?
No.
No. No. You see, they're going to have that lived-in look, you know. And sometimes, not just the kids, but mom and dad, you know, we have that lived-in look. We got, you know, that's our private sanctuary, and you know, that's where we go. Nobody else, and, you know, people coming in visiting, that's where they're coming. But we have that, you know, and we got, we're going to talk about a little bit about Christmas trees in a little bit, you know. A lot of times people like to put a Christmas tree up in a room that's got their wood stove in or fireplace in. That can be dangerous too, because it dries that tree out quicker. So we'll talk a little bit about that a little bit later. But right now, I really wanted to reiterate that about the heat and safety with the small heaters and things like that. Make sure that they're plugged in properly, not running off a drop cord. We've seen small heaters that's actually been trying to run off a drop cord, and they weren't designed to run off a drop cord.
Right, and that's where you get feel your drop cord. Your drop cord is awful hot.
Yeah,
where it's overheating.
Yeah, that or you got your drop cord laying there running over to your heater. We pile clothes on it or pile up other materials on top of that cord, and it, like I say, it starts heating up. It's sort of like a hose pipe. You know, I've seen drop cords that, you know, you don't think about it, but you drink and you kink them or something like that. They're sort of similar to a water hose. You know, when you kink a water hose, what are you doing to the water?
Restricting its flow.
You're restricting the flow. You're causing the flow. Electrical cord can do this, can in a sense do the same thing. You can restrict it and cause it to heat up and cause it to could start a fire or short out and cause a fire. So be extra cautious if you can with those electric heaters. If you use them, and like I say, they're if you use them properly and read the manufacturer's instructions on them, they're safe little heaters to use. But if you got to plug them in, try to plug them into the outlet. Because that's the safest way you can do it. Plug them in straight into the outlet. You know, but like I said, when we get back a while ago, that 3 feet and 3 to 5 feet. You know, make sure that's our safe zone. Make sure we stay there. And if you're not going to be in your room and you don't really need the heat going, go ahead and make sure you turn those heaters off. Make sure they're turned off. They're needing them sitting in there running. It could be close to something other. You could have a pet in the house. What do they do? they get curious. They can move things around. They look at things. Cats, dogs, whatever. You know. They're curious much, and they want to see what's going on. They get in there and get to playing with it, and could drag something over it, and not. Next thing you know, you have a fire just because of their curiosity. So if you're not in the room or not there, turn them off.
Man, I know you with your space heater, but you also got your portable kerosene heaters, which, you know, we'll make sure that you keep plenty of space between them. But also, you got your concerns with your carbon monoxide. You got concerns with refilling the heater when the kerosene runs out.
Mm-hmm. With the kerosene heater, like I say, they're safe plants if they're kept up and maintained. That's the biggest problem we're finding with sometimes that they're not maintained like they're supposed to be. If you read the manufacturer's recommendations on a kerosene heater, it says use it in a vented room. It has to have air.
Right.
If you don't, you're burning a carbon-based fuel inside of a house, and it is putting on carbon monoxide. If you're going to have a kerosene heater in your house or a gas appliance or even a regular oil furnace in the house, I do recommend you having a carbon monoxide detector in your house, because something could go wrong with any one of these appliances, and the next thing you know, you've got carbon monoxide. And it's a silent killer. You don't realize it's there. I had a lady call me, it's been probably a couple of years ago, and she said, something just ain't right in my house. Could you come up and check it for me? You know, I went up to check her house. As soon as I walked in the house, my eyes started burning, my nose started burning, and I could tell something wasn't right. And come to find out, her furnace, the firebox had a crack in it, and it was dumping all the carbon monoxide into her house. Luckily, she didn't die. She could have easily have passed away there in that house.
Right.
We was able to get her out of the house, shut the furnace down until we could get somebody there to check the furnace, make sure, and that's when we found out it had a crack in the firebox. But these things are dangerous. You know, need to maintain them. Get your furnace system, especially if you got gas or oil units like that, or any unit, any heating system you got. You need to maintain it and get it at least checked out once a year to make sure it's running properly. When it comes to, you talked about the kerosene heater, when fueling it, don't fuel it inside the house. I've seen that happen. I've seen the house burnt to the ground because that man was fueling the kerosene heater inside the house while his kerosene heater was still burning. You know, you need to shut it off. If it's got some of these units have built-in tanks, take it outside, let it cool off, use the proper funnel and everything like that to fill it up. If you spill it on a kerosene heater, make sure it's wiped up, cleaned up before you take it back into the house and relight it. Fill one inside. And we have that happen all the time. They try to fill them up on the inside. So just be cautious with that. Fireplaces, wood stoves. If you got a wood stove, make sure the door stays shut. Fireplace, make sure we have a proper screen in front of it, because logs can roll out of that fireplace. You may have a set of good fire dogs in there, but if you're not careful how you place a log after it gets burning, I have seen them roll out into the floor and catch a house on fire that way. So make sure right now we're getting into our Christmas season and the holiday season. We got a lot of things going on. Make sure you properly take care of things and slow down a little bit when it comes to the heating units and I'll make sure they're properly taken care of before you leave. And we're going to talk a little bit about some winter fires. Ashes. I have seen people, I don't know if they're thinking, they're not thinking. They take up ashes, they think you're cool, but they'll take up ashes in a plastic buck. And I know you've seen it, because I know you're a fireman also, and you've been out there on fires, and here's the bucket, plastic bucket with hot ashes in it. Where's that bucket? You find the bucket.
Normally it's found on the porch. We actually find it under the porch, melted, where it set the porch on fire.
Yeah. I've done that. I've seen that, and I've actually seen, going out over the years investigating fires, another thing to use, and you're saying, you ain't never seen people use it, a cardboard box.
That's right.
Would a cardboard box burn? Mm-hmm. Yes, I've been out there on fires, and the gentleman had got up his ashes. I actually had a fire over in Jacobs Creek area where the gentleman got up his ashes in a box. His wood stove was in the basement. He had some wood pile, stacked up in the basement. He dumped his ashes into the box, but got in a hurry because it was Sunday afternoon and he was going back to church at night. Set his box on a wood pile right there beside the stove, forgot to take it out. When he come back home from church, his house smoked up. And actually the box had done burnt down into the wood and set the wood on fire there where he had stacked up to put in the wood stove. But it was burning in his basement. So get a good metal bucket and dump your ashes out. Actually, if you want to take it on out in the yard, put some water on it. Let it sit there and soak for the day. And people say, you can let it sit out. I've seen ashes sit out in the yard 3 or 4 days and still be hot. Down inside the bucket, in metal bucket.
Right.
And I've seen them take them to the edge of the woods in a plastic bucket or the cardboard box. And the next thing you know, what we got?
A woods fire.
We got a woods fire. So our heating safety, we got to really, really be cautious this time of year, especially this time of month in December, because there's a lot of things going on. We talked earlier about parades. We talked, there's Christmas parties, there's Christmas things going on at the church, there's different things going on throughout the community. You're in a hurry to get there from work, or you're doing something on the weekend and you get in a hurry to get there, you're going Christmas shopping or something like that. We need to slow down and think about this, because these little small things that we might forget can end up costing us big.
Right.
So we need to really be, really watch that. And also, but make sure you maintain them. Make sure you keep that distance. You have a CO detector, and you should be safe. Right. You should be safe with these heaters.
I know some sheet you gave me on some winter fire. Got some interesting facts on it. One thing I didn't really never thought about, but it's showing in here that half of all the home heating fires occur in 3 months. Which is December, January, and February.
They do. During that time, those are the hustle bustle times. The December, especially with, like we said, just mentioned earlier, with the holidays. And then we got January and February come up, the colder months. We're trying to heat, putting a little more heat to the house because of the cold weather. And a lot of it is just we get complacency with it. We've done this year after year after year. We've done this. you need to just keep heads up on what's going on with this, and make sure that. Another thing, you see, during those months, we got things that freeze up. Our water pipes freeze up. We're getting under there with a little torch to try to thaw the pipes out and trying to get them to, getting our water to flow. A lot of times these pipes are mounted to what? Wood. And we're putting a flame on that pipe. But we're also putting that flame on what?
On the wood.
On the wood. So, you need to really be cautious when we get on, because, like I say, we're under there trying to thaw out these pipes. We're trying to get our water going again, because the kids, mama, everybody's fussing at us because the water ain't going. They want that water. They want to take a shower. They want to cook. They want to do this. So we're under there trying to get it done as quickly as possible. As soon as we hear the water go, we don't think about keeping an eye on what we've just done. Because under the basement, under the crawl spaces of our houses, we have spider webs that's done got under there, dust. The lumber under there's done dried out.
Right.
And we throw in this nice blue flame, this nice flame to that all that wood, and it's, it easily could catch a house on fire. That's why you see in this, most all the fires occurring in the winter months here. And also just be extra cautious when doing that. And, you're seeing that just down below that. 1 in 6 fires is caused by heating units. We just got through talking about a fire and heating units there, making sure. And also, it talks about 1 in every 5 homes we have a fire death.
Right.
Due to it because of some kind of fire. I was just reading in the news this morning where 2 family members passed away in a house fire in the last day. So, and not sure if it was coming from heating or something happened in the kitchen. And also, we got to, be cautious of that.
Well, I see, Tommy, it's about time for us to take a quick break. When we come back, we'll finish up on that, and we'll start talking about some Christmas.
Yes, sir.
WLOE, Eden. WMYN, Mayodan. Listen online all the time. RockinghamCountyRadio.com.
All right, Tommy, we're back, and we were talking about some heat and safety, and we were giving them a few tips. We'll go ahead and finish up on some of the tips we got here, and then we'll start talking about holiday safety.
Okay. Again, on a lot of the tips, making sure that your heaters, portable heaters, get that 3 to 5 feet distance. Our carbon monoxide, make sure we put those carbon monoxide in there. Ashes. At least 10 to 20 feet away from a house if possible. But don't set them in a pile of leaves out there next to the edge of the woods.
And make sure we store them in a metal can.
A metal can with a lid on it if possible. Make sure we got a good metal can with a metal lid on it if possible. Not the plastic bucket, not the cardboard box, nothing like that. Make sure that. Make sure our appliances are plugged in directly to the outlet. Not running them off drop cord. Check your appliance. After you've had it stored all summer, make sure the cords are not frayed and not shorted out and everything like that. Just generally give a good check over and don't just check over it one time. Check on it every so often. Check that heater, check that cord and everything, making sure everything is working properly. Because something it's man-made, and something can always happen or malfunction could occur. So just keep an eye on everything and make sure it's working properly. And if you leave, if you're not going to use it in a certain area,
cut it off,
especially if you're leaving, going out of town, going out shopping and everything. If you don't need it, cut it off. Okay?
Yeah, like I said, we got holiday safety because, Christmas is coming up and I've already seen Christmas trees being put up and Christmas lights being put up.
Yes.
And I've also seen candles being put in the windows.
Candles, yes. This time of year, you'd think we'd use candles all during the year. But during this time of year, a lot of our fires occur because of candles. This is our biggest use of candles is coming up this month of December. is when we see the most usage of candles. Because a lot of them like to get that, you can get the candle that's got that cedar smell to it, or got that cinnamon smell to it, or spicy smell to it, and we want to burn and get that ambiance, or get the smell of the holiday season in our house, you know, with that, those scented candles. Bad thing is we don't think about where we place them or what kind of container we're placing them in. We may just set the candle up there and light it, you know, which is not a good thing. You should have some kind of plate, saucer, or something under that candle sits in, or a container that to put the candle in to properly burn it, you know. Make sure it's located in a safe location. Right. I've seen garlic, nice green, not artificial garland, but nice real green garland put up there. Well, I see candles stuck in different places in around that, and they're sitting there burning. Right.
Drying it out
and waiting for a fire to happen right there. So,
I know nearly two out of every five home decoration fires is a result of a candle.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Yep. And like I say, it's just we love to see them. And again, that's another thing. As long as they're used properly, they can be safe. But the thing is, you got the candle burning. Again, we got pets running around the house. And they see that little flame flickering, and they're curious of what's going on. What's going on up there? I see that little light flickering up there. Or we got children running around the house, knocking things over, or, you know, not meaning to knock things over, but they're just running and having a good time because they're getting the Christmas spirit and they're having a good time. Mm-hmm. And knock a candle over. So be extra, extra cautious if you want to burn the candles.
Right. Well, besides candles, we also, obviously, we have, you know, we saw Christmas lights being put up.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the biggest things in the past we've seen is people putting too many light strands together, which causes you short, and next thing you know, here we go again with a fire.
Yep. I have seen strand after strand after strand put in, and then they hook them, you know, the lights have got where you can hook them together, right. So they hook together, and then we run them into a drop cord, another 100-foot, 25-foot, 50-foot of drop cord running out there. And they plug it in, and they keep saying, well, why does my breaker keep shutting off, keep going off? Well, you're overloading the circuit, and you keep overloading. Eventually, it's gonna have a fire there. It's going to short out, and it's going to have a fire. Or you're going to overheat your drop cord. And putting up your Christmas lights, make sure they're beautiful. They're safe appliance if used properly. Now, you hear me constantly say they're a safe appliance if you use properly. That's the thing we got to watch. We got to make sure we're using them properly, you know, making sure we're not plugging too many. If you read a lot of times on the boxes, it'll recommend how many can be plugged in together before you have to start a separate thing. Some may be three, some may be four. You know, you may have some that's just two can be plugged in. Right. And again, you may have just one can be plugged in. It just depends on what they are, the size of the lights, the size of the bulb. We got a lot of new lights that's coming out with the LED.
Right.
They burn a lot cooler, burn a lot less electricity, a lot more energy efficient than the old great big old bulbs we used to have, you know. It could easily set things on fire. If you're putting them up on the edge of the house, we still got leaves falling. I've been, you know, you've been riding through the county. What do you see piled up on top of the house?
Leaves.
The gutters may be full of leaves. And here we are attaching something electrical that could cause an electrical hazard. Right there where we got a fire source with these dried leaves. Right. Putting them up. A lot of people like to use this staple gun.
Right through the wire.
I've seen that done a number of times. I've seen a house that actually they've put the lights up. It was stapling it up. It had not the old vinyl, but you know, it didn't have vinyl siding. They used to have that metal siding, you know, looked like the vinyl siding we have now. They actually energized the house. Yes. You know, so you got to be cautious when you run that staple gun in there. Make sure it's getting in the center so it's going across, not through the wiring, so it can create that short. Holiday safe lights, you know, are beautiful and they can be safe. Just done. Make sure they're hanging properly. and keep your candles away from things. And you can buy clips and everything, hang lights with it, Lowe's and hardware stores and stuff like that. Just make sure you do that, you know.
Then, of course, you got our favorite, which is Christmas trees.
Christmas trees, yes.
And, you know, everybody, especially, I can vouch for myself, I'd much rather have a live Christmas tree versus an artificial any day.
Mm-hmm.
I like the smell of them.
Mm-hmm.
But unfortunately, with the live tree, you know, there's some things that we have to do to make sure they stay stay alive while they're in our house, because with all the heat that's in the house, ambient heat is going to start drying them out, and which in turn, you know, most people have seen the YouTube videos when a Christmas tree lights up. You know, that's probably one of the fastest burning items I've ever seen.
It is. It's like, it's just like having a gasoline can in there and you're, and pulling gas on, and it's just like pure gas, almost like what it is. And Christmas trees, they're beautiful. They, you know, real ones, like you say, are good to have in the house. They, you know, as long as you, again, you got to maintain that tree. You got to properly take care of your Christmas tree. You can't just set it in there and forget it. You gotta water it daily. And if you got it in a room that's got a wood stove, you probably have to water it more than daily. You might have to put water to it twice a day, because you got that dry heat in there that's sucking all that moisture out of that tree. So you're going to have to keep that water to that tree a lot more. Big thing when putting lights, check your strand of lights before you're putting it on that tree, making sure you don't have any frays or anything that could short out and cause it. One of the facts is one of every three home fires with a Christmas tree is electrical failure. Causes that tree to catch on fire. So check your electrical thing. I had a lady brought me a Christmas angel topper.
Right.
She said she was in her house, and she was walking through the house. She started smelling something, smelled like smoke or plastic burning. She said she searched and she searched and she searched, and she couldn't see. Can't figure it out. And said she went back into the room where the Christmas tree was, and she said it smelled like it was in there the most. Come to find out what she'd done with the Christmas angel when she took it out and she last year and put it back up. She had wrapped a cord around the skirt of the angel. So what it does, it's got a plastic cone up under the skirt that holds that skirt out, makes it look pretty. But what she had done when she wrapped that cord around it, she had crushed all that plastic in on all the lights. So what it was doing after the angel burnt for a while and got warm, that plastic had just started burning and melting under there. And that's what she was smelling. So that's, again, you should look at your lights and everything as you put them on to make sure that they're still safe. And make sure there's no frays, broken places in the wire, stuff like that. Make sure it's that, and we can cut down on that.
Right. Real quick, I see we're about out of time. Just, we'll make sure on your Christmas trees that we, you know, like you just said, water them.
Water.
And when your placement, you want to make sure that you don't block an exit, and you want to make sure that we keep it at least 3 feet away from any heat source.
Yep.
As you've been saying all morning.
Yep.
Any other safety tips that you can think of, Tommy?
No, just briefly, one of the biggest safety tips during this holiday season is make sure that's smoke protector. That's the biggest safety tip I can give you. Make sure you have that working smoke detector in your home. Make sure that if you go to bed at night, you'll have something that'll wake you up and get you out of the house in case you do have a fire.
All right. As ever, for more information or if anybody needs any further fire safety tips, if you would, you can give us a call at our office.
Yes. You can call my office at 634-3007. If I'm not in, I'm in and out a lot. If I'm not in, just leave me a message and I'll get back with you.
Well, I do appreciate it, Tommy, and we hope everybody has a Merry Christmas.
Yes.